When we first learned to multiply and divide positive and negative numbers, we saw, well, look, if you have a positive number times a positive number, I'm just writing pos for short for positive, well, that of course is going to be equal to a positive number. That you saw that even before you learned about negative numbers. But it was also true if you had the same sign, a negative times a negative, that was also going to be equal to a positive number. And that the way that you get a negative number is if you multiply or divide something of different signs. So if you have a positive times a negative, that would give you a negative number. Or if you had a negative, negative times a positive, that also would give you a negative number. And here I wrote it for multiplication, but it also applies to division. A negative divided by a negative is positive. A negative divided by a positive would be negative. Now all of these we thought about if we're only multiplying or dividing two things. But I'll just think about what happens if we multiply or divide three things, or four things, or five things, or n things together, what we might expect. So let's say that we were to multiply a times, and now I'm going to write the dot for times, a times b times c. A times b times c. Now, if I told you that these were all positive numbers, then you'd say, okay, a times b times c is going to be positive. A times b would be positive, and then that times c is positive. Now, what would happen if I were to tell you that they were all negative numbers? What if a, b, and c were all negative? Well, if they were all negative, let me write it that way. Let me write a, b, and c. A, b, and c, they're all going to be negative. So if that's the case, what is this product going to be equal to? Well, you're going to have a negative here times a negative. So a negative times a negative, a times b, if you do that first, and we can when we multiply these numbers, that's going to give you a positive. So a times b is going to give you a positive, but then you're going to multiply that times c. You're going to multiply that times c, which is a negative. So you're going to have a positive times a negative, which is going to be a negative. So this one, if a, b, and c are all less than 0, then the product a, b, c is going to be less than 0 as well. This whole thing is going to be negative. Now, if I did something else, if I said, there's other ways that I can make the product negative. If a is, let's say that a, actually, let me just write it this way. Let's say that a is positive, b is negative, and c is positive. Well, here, positive times a negative, if you do this first, positive times a negative is going to give you a negative. And then a negative times a positive, different signs, is going to give you a negative. So this whole thing is going to be a negative. But let's keep doing. We said, look, if all of them were negative, then this thing would be negative. But that's because I had three numbers here. What if I had four numbers here? What if I had times d here? And if I told you all of these numbers were negative? Well, let's think about it. Negative. And I can do the multiplication in any order, but I'll just go left to right. A times b, negative times a negative, that would yield a positive. Now, if you multiply that product times c, positive times a negative, that would give you a negative. And then you multiply this negative times this negative, so this whole product ABC is going to be negative. But then we multiply it times a negative. Well, negative times a negative is going to be a positive. So this whole thing is going to be a positive. And so you're probably seeing a pattern here. If you're multiplying a bunch of numbers, and if you have an odd number of negatives being multiplied and or divided. I just did multiplication here, but this would have also been true if these were all division symbols. We would have been able to say the exact same thing. If you have an odd number of negative numbers in your product or in your quotient, well, then you're going to have a negative value for the entire expression. If you have an even number of negative, well then the whole thing is going to be positive. And so you can view these as generalizations of what we just saw here. Positive times a positive, you have zero negatives. Zero is actually an even number, so this would be positive. negative times a negative? Well, that's an even number of negatives. You have two negatives. So that's this case again. That's this case again. So you're going to be positive. Either of these cases, you have one negative. You have one negative in either of these cases. So that's going to be this case, odd number of negatives. So it's going to be a negative. And so we can use this knowledge to start dealing with negative numbers and exponents. So if I were to say I have a to the, let me throw out a wild number here, a to the 101st power, and we know that a is less than 0, what is this going to be? Well, this is taking 101 a's and multiplying them together. You have an odd number of negatives being multiplied together. Well, this whole thing is going to be less than 0. If we knew what a was, we could calculate it somehow, but we know that this thing is going to be negative. Now let's do something, and we could do it other ways. We could say something like this. Let me try another one. What if I tell you that a is less than 0 and b is also less than 0? And if I had a to the 101 power divided by b to the 7th power, what would this expression be? Would it be positive or negative? Or 0 maybe? Well, you see here, a to the 101st power, you have an odd number of negative numbers being multiplied. So this whole thing is going to be negative. And the same thing applies here. You have a negative number to an odd power. You have an odd number of this negative number being multiplied together. So that's going to be negative. But then you have a negative divided by a negative. A negative divided by a negative is going to be a positive. So this thing right here is going to be positive. So this is just a beginning. And in the next few videos, we'll actually do a bunch of examples that really test our understanding of this.